A few weeks ago I showed you this PCB hot plate which can reflow other PCBs, but things didn't go exactly as planned.
The solder mask just doesn't like the heat.
Long story short, aluminium PCBs are not meant to operate at those high temperatures, but that doesn't mean there aren't any other materials that can do that.
That is one freaking cool PCB.
These two new boards are made from polyamide materials. This means that they should be more resistant to heat and they should also have a lower thermal expansion. My hot plate design didn't change much from the previous version, but I made sure to take advantage of some new features these new materials unlock.
I'm going to start by testing this flexible PCB. This is the normal flexible PCB polyamide material, which also has a steel stiffener so that can keep the heat distribution even.
The thickness of this stiffener is 0.5 millimeters, which makes the PCB quite rigid.
The steel is not 100% perfect because it has some scratches on the back, but this combination just makes the PCB look gorgeous. And it also has this harness, which I absolutely love. PCBWay has already specified to me that the TCG value of this material should be 290 degrees Celsius, so this time we should be more than okay.
The track resistance of this PCB was a little smaller than that of version 2 because PCBWay suggested to double the copper thickness to increase reliability, but V equals IR, so we're only going to draw more current at lower voltages. In fact, the PCB managed to reach 207 degrees Celsius at just 7 volts. Now I left the PCB running at this temperature for around 3 hours, and this is when all my hopes for this project got burned up. First, the PCB started puffing up a little bubble in the middle. This probably happened because of the steel stiffener's adhesive, which may not be rated to go to this temperature. But then, halfway through the test, the top polyamide cover layer started discoloring.
A very interesting observation is that the bubble disappeared after cooling off, and it also seems that the darkening happened where the bubble was. I was not expecting such a bad results from polyamide flex PCB, so I'm really disappointed. Our next hope is going to be the SH260 material.
This SH260 PCB is also polyamide based, and according to PCBWay's website, it should have a TG rating of at least 250 degrees Celsius. It also has a darker purple color than the V2 PCBs, so it was a little bit harder to detect the change in color in the 200 degrees 3 hours test. But eventually it also started discoloring, which basically means that these two new prototypes doesn't look any better than the previous aluminium core PCB.
So does these PCBs really have high TG values? To get some answers, I opened a dispute with my PCB manufacturer about this, which is kind of disgraceful from my end because these were sponsored and given to me for free. But all jokes aside, I got some pretty interesting answers. PCBWay has confirmed that there were no manufacturing mistake and the TG rating is in fact correct. They asked me to make one specific test, heat the board from the outside rather than from the inside. And this clue basically had all the answers I needed.
I think the problem has to do with the fact that we're measuring this point over here, which we're saying it is 200 degrees Celsius. So for this point to reach this temperature, the copper must be at a much higher value.
Unfortunately, I don't have a thermal chamber, so I heated the board to 200 degrees using my hot plate. And after 3 hours, there were no noticeable defects. So the next thing I did is scrape off some coverlay to measure the temperature of the copper, and I found that it was around 25 degrees Celsius higher.
I'm so dumb, why haven't I figured this out from day one?
Now my PCB manufacturer also told me that their temperature ratings are a function of time. These are the recommended time periods they gave me for these three different operating temperatures. So things are not looking that good for this PCB hot plate. As I've showed, you can reflow PCBs with it, but turning it into a kit and selling it, it's not that good of an idea. There is another material that have better thermal properties than polyamide, and that is ceramic PCBs. But it's way more expensive, so it doesn't keep the idea feasible. In the future, I'm still considering to make some other thermal related projects, but I need to keep in mind that the maximum temperature rating needs to be much lower, or at least keep the same maximum temperature, but for a lower duration and time. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.